aspirants, welcome to AKSIS. This is the last video which covers the current affairs related to the February current affairs magazine. And now let us see some of the topics related to the state of Andhra Pradesh. Our first topic is about the Pothireddipadu head regulator. The state government of AP has announced to widen the Pothireddipadu head regulator because, see, this Pothireddipadu head regulator, the water that is being discharged to this regulator is not being met the demand of this area. So to meet the demand, to provide the water supply to meet the demand, this head regulator is being considered to be widened, thereby enhancing the discharging capacity of this regulator from the current 44,000 cusecs to 80,000 cusecs. This Pothireddipadu head regulator is also known as the Veligodu reservoir across the Galeru River. So to increase the supply, the existing infrastructure is not enough. So to develop the state government has now taking measures to develop the infrastructure so that these flood waters from the Krishna region can be, the surplus waters from the Krishna water can be diverted to these areas. That is the regions of Rayalaseema. These projects will cater to the drinking water and irrigation water needs of this Rayalaseema region. Our next topic is about the YSR Lifetime Achievement Award. State government has constituted a high power committee headed by the Principal Secretary to select the recipients of this YSR Lifetime Award for providing excellent public service. The award will be given on January 26, that is on the Republic Day, and on the Independence Day on August 15. So on both these days, the award will be given to the recipients. This award will carry 10 lakh rupees cash prize and a citation. The committee headed by the Principal Secretary, the nominations that have came to this committee will be examined by this committee, and this committee will select the suitable recipients of this award. Our next topic is about the Andhra Pradesh Pollution Control Board and the noise pollution. So for the first time, AP Pollution Control Board has drafted a plan which concentrate exclusively on the noise pollution. So this is in the backdrop that National Green Tribunal has issued orders to draft a plan to check the noise pollution levels and take preventive measures in the cities and the towns. It has been found the noise pollution levels in cities and towns has been increased throughout the country. On that backdrop, National Green Tribunal has issued orders to draft a plan to check noise pollution levels in cities and towns. So the AP Pollution Control Board has drafted a plan which exclusively concentrate on the noise pollution. Pollution Control Board has been installing the real-time noise monitoring stations to watch or to see the levels, to check the noise pollution levels. First category is industrial, second category commercial and residential, and the last one is sensitive areas. The four categories or four zonations with respect to noise pollution. So in the industrial areas, morning times the maximum noise pollution is 75 decibels, during nights it is 70 decibels. In the commercial areas, in the morning times the maximum noise pollution that can be is the maximum noise pollution that has been prescribed is 65 decibels. In the night times it is 55 decibels. In residential areas it is 55 decibels in the morning and 45 decibels in the night, during night. In the sensitive areas, in the morning times it is 50 decibels, night time it is 40 decibels. Sensitive areas include hospitals and the school areas, etc. If these limits have breached, the long-term exposure to such a high noise level will have so many detrimental impacts on the health, overall well-being of an individual. Now let us see the details of the NGT order in this regard. So the actions to be taken are mentioned in this column, and the term or the time frame within which these actions to be implemented, and the authorities responsible or the departments responsible to take these actions, all have been listed out here. If we see here, implementation of noise rules and regulations issued by the National Green Tribunal under the Noise Pollution Regulation and Control Act 2000 and the later amendments to this. So these have to be taken or implemented within 6 months period, and the implementation of the same has to be taken as a regular continued activity. So the departments or the authorities responsible to take up this include police department, transportation department, urban local bodies and the state pollution control board. This is with regarding to the implementation of the noise pollution rules which are mentioned in the Noise Pollution Regulation and Control Act of 2000. And the next action to be taken is procurement of noise level monitoring devices. So this has to be implemented within short term and medium term period, that is within 6 months and 6 months to 1 year. The procurement of the portable handheld devices has to be procured within 6 months, whereas the real time continuous online stationary devices have to be procured within 1 year as directed by the National Green Tribunal. And again, the bodies or the departments responsible for this activity: police, transport department, urban local bodies and the state pollution control board. And the next action is to strengthen the noise monitoring network with at least one real-time noise monitoring network to be located in the district headquarters. So this has to be completed within 6 months to 2 years. This action has to be taken up by the state level pollution control board. And the next action to be taken, to launch the public awareness campaigns to reduce the noise levels. So it is very obvious that it has to be a continuous process. At least it has to be initiated within 6 months. Main body that it needs to be taken up is by the state level pollution control board with the coordination of all other bodies. So that's all about the noise pollution. Our next topic is about the project Tata. Let us see what is Tata. Tata here means training and activities for technology adoption. Context here is this training and activities for technology adoption has been launched for the first time by the Ongole police. This is the first of its kind initiative, that too at the district level. So the primary aim of this initiative, that is the Tata initiative, is to provide the technical knowledge, the technical expertise to every person in the police force, from the constable to the deputy superintendent of police, to for all those people, to provide them with the technical knowledge. So for that purpose, under this project, training will be given on introduction and adoption of various applications such as CDR, that is call detail records, which can be used to track the call details, and also CIG, that is Criminal Intelligence Gazette, in which data of the missing persons, unidentified dead bodies, interstate criminal gangs and the stolen vehicles are all stored. So with respect to all these applications and other technologies, the training is very important to be given to the police forces. For that purpose, this Tata project has been taken up by the police, Ongole police. This is the first of its kind that is initiated at the district levels. Our next topic is about the Gandikota festival. The Gandikota festival is taken up by the or organized by the state government to promote tourism in the state. So this Gandikota festival, the Gandikota port is located in Jammalmadugu mandal, and the annual festival, the Gandikota festival, is organized every year by the Department of Tourism to promote tourism. Since 2015 it is being celebrated or it's being organized. If we go back to the history of this Gandikota port, it was constructed in the year 1123 AD, way back in the 12th century, by the King Kakaraju. And this same port has been renovated by the Vijayanagara kings in the year 1336 AD. The Gandikota port is situated on top of a hill above 1670 feet above the sea level. It is located 105 kilometers away from the Kadapa headquarters and 20 kilometers from the Jammalmadugu mandal. The state government had also taken up the ropeway project with a cost of 7 crore rupees to reach the Agastya Kona from this Gandikota temple port. Our next topic is on the statistics related to former suicides in Andhra Pradesh. The National Crime Records Bureau has released the statistics. So when compared from the year 2016 and 17, the number of former suicides in 2018 have been decreased. The number in 2016 is 565, in 2017 441, The same in 2018 is 299. Though the total number of incidents have come down, still this number is too high. So AP still is among the top 5 states with highest number of farmer suicides, Maharashtra and Karnataka being the top 2 states. Our next topic is about Ammavadi project, Ammavadi scheme that is being implemented from January 26, 2020. Now let us see some of the details of this Ammavadi scheme. Under this scheme, 15,000 cash benefits will be transferred to the account, mother's bank account, if the mother sends her child to school. Students from both government schools as well as the private schools are eligible for this scheme. The main objective behind this cash incentivization is to incentivize the mothers to send their children to school to reduce the dropout rates in these schools, thereby enhance the child's chances to get educated. It has been said that already 30% more enrollment rate has been recorded because of this announcement of this scheme. To be eligible for this cash incentivization, there should be at least 75% of attendance. And the beneficiaries, that is the mother and the child, should have Aadhaar card and mother should have bank account. Now let us see some of the current affairs related to the state of Telangana. Our first topic here is about check dams. Telangana government has proposed to construct around 600 check dams across the state. Check dams are nothing but these small scale dams which will have less financial cost and less ecological cost as well. Of these 600 check dams, 84 check dams have been proposed to be constructed in Adilabad district. Adilabad is a hilly district with a number of hilly streams, but there is no water harvesting project within the district. So now this 84 check dams have been proposed to be constructed in the district. The construction of these check dams will improve the water storage and the ground and water percolation to reach the groundwater, thereby increasing the levels of the groundwater, and this will take care of the drinking and the irrigation needs of the local populations. Our next topic is on the Telangana Police She Teams. The She Teams has launched a WhatsApp group, WhatsApp number, wherein women across the state can report various kinds of grievances on this WhatsApp helpline. The grievances related to domestic violence, sexual harassment or sexual harassment to stalking and all other kinds of harassments can be reported through this WhatsApp helpline. It's a 24/7, but it can be useful only for the non-emergency purposes. For the emergency purposes, one can use 100 or 112. All districts of Telangana have the dedicated She Teams and their new numbers to help channelize the grievance redressal mechanism to the victims. The Telangana Police has taken up this year as to dedicated to the women's safety and the road safety. So this is not just the duty of the Telangana Police. All the citizens of the state, all the residents of the states have to take up, the communities deciding in the states have to take up this women's safety and the road safety. Our next topic is about the Spice Board of India. The context is an extension office, regional office of the Spice Board of India is proposed to be set up in the Nizamabad district. Spice Board of India is one of the 5 statutory commodity boards under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. This board has set up in the year 1987 under the Spice Board Act of 1986. The primary responsibility of this commodity board is to promote the production, development and as well as the exports of the spices within India. For these purposes, Spice Board takes up various functions which range from setting up of quality checking centers and also to promote the post-harvest cold storages and supply chains. So various such aspects will be taken up by the Spice Board. The residents of Telangana are seeking for the setting up of the turmeric board. The turmeric farmers are seeking up to set up the turmeric board, but the central government is saying spice board will be enough. It will take care of the same things with respect to turmeric production and export as well. So the central government is setting up of the extension of this regional office of the Spice Board of India. There is a scheme to promote the export and to provide the infrastructure needed for the export, which is named as the Trade Infrastructure for the Export Scheme. Under this scheme, the appropriate infrastructure needed for the development and the growth of the exports in the country will be created. The finance will be provided under this scheme. And under this, the central and the state agencies will engage to develop the infrastructure related to the exports. This TAI scheme has been launched in the year 2017. Prior to this body, there was a body named as ASSAID, which means Assistance to States for Developing Export Infrastructure and Other Allied Activities. This was set aside after the 14th Finance Commission's recommendations, which said the 42% devolution and the total divisible pool, whereby state governments get extra 10% of these in the free funds. So this scheme has been set aside because now the state governments have the extra fund with them. They can utilize that fund to promote the exports. But even after that, many state governments have requested to have some assistance, to provide some assistance to develop the required infrastructure for the promotion of exports. So then the central government has came up with this TAI scheme in the year 2017. The ASSAID scheme has set aside in the year 2015. Now under the TAI scheme, the central government is providing assistance for the development of the infrastructure for the export promotion of exports. So earlier we have seen there are 5 statutory commodity boards in India, which works under the Department of Commerce, under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. The other statutory commodity boards include the Tea Board, Coffee Board, Rubber Board and the Tobacco Board. So these are the 5 statutory commodity boards. There can be other commodity boards, but these are the 5 statutory commodity boards. Our next topic is about the Padma Awards. So 3 people from Telangana got the Padma Awards. P.V. Sindhu got Padma Vibhushan, whereas Chintala Venkata Reddy and the Vijaya Sarathi Sribhashyam got the Padma Shri Award. P.V. Sindhu has got this award after 2019 BWF World Championship. She won this championship with gold medal. She has conferred with the 3rd highest civilian honor of the country, that is with Padma Bhushan. It is actually 3rd highest, not 2nd. 1st is Bharat Ratna, 2nd is Padma Vibhushan, 3rd is Padma Bhushan and the 4th is Padma Shri. Padma Shri award has been conferred on 2 people from the state, that include Chintala Venkata Reddy. He has been conferred for his services in the field of agriculture, and Vijay Sarathi Sribhashyam in the field of literature and education. So Chintala Venkata Reddy is famous for his innovative usage of the organic soil in organic farming, and he has in fact got the international patent for the invention of a process to improve the quality of the topsoil. For his services, the government has recognized him with the Padma Shri Award. So Vijay Sarathi Sribhashyam, a 84-year-old Sanskrit scholar, has been conferred with the Padma Shri. He is a poet and he has written more than 100 literary works. In 2017, he has received the Best Sanskrit Scholar Award from the state government. He has penned many epic works. Our next topic is about the modernization of the Anganwadis, digitization of the Anganwadis. The plan to digitize the Anganwadis is in consideration, is in progress actually in the state of Telangana. The aim is basically is to improve the standards of the preschooling. The Department of Women Development and Child Welfare has initiated this first of its kind to digitize the total curriculum and the pedagogy for the preschoolers, that is the children who go to Anganwadis. So this is very important in the backdrop that most of the Anganwadi teachers are below the 10th class level. They have got their education below the 10th class level, and they will have limited training as well. They will be provided very limited training. In that context, it will become very important to provide these children, the preschoolers, with the digital classrooms, digital courses. Our next topic is about the investments that the Telangana government has signed with various companies during the IT minister's participation in the World Economic Forum. Our next topic is about the excellence in adopting emerging technologies. The state government of Telangana has given this award for adopting the blockchain project for administering the chit funds and the T-chits. So this blockchain technology adoption in the chit funds has increased the transparency of the transactions, and it made automated and trusted financial transaction between all the parties. So because of this measure, this move, the state government has got excellence in adopting emerging technologies award at the 23rd National Conference on E-Governance for the year 2019 and 2020. So the blockchain technology basically increased the trust and transparency of the chit fund processes. Our next topic is about the air pollution in the 9 cities of Telangana. So air quality in 9 cities of Telangana has found severely polluted. The Greenpeace report named Airpocalypse. So according to this report, 9 cities in Telangana are severely polluted. This particular Greenpeace NGO has analyzed air pollution in 287 Indian cities and has monitored for 52 days in the year 2018 under the Project National Ambient Air Quality Monitoring Program. So through these observations, the Greenpeace has released a report named Airpocalypse. So the report says that out of these 287 Indian cities, 231 cities, including 9 cities in Telangana, are severely polluted with PM10, that is particulate matter size 10 levels exceeding the ambient levels which has been prescribed in the National Ambient Air Quality Standards. So these cities, the levels have breached the standards given under this. PM10 is nothing but a fine particulate matter of size less than 10 micrometer. Presence of PM10 or PM2.5 in the air will cause respiratory and the lung diseases. Our next topic is about Telangana government is being studied or implementing the same model as that is implemented by the Kerala for catering the needs of the non-residents of these states, such as non-resident Keralites. Though Kerala has taken up some model to cater to the needs of the non-resident Keralites, the same model is being implemented, is being considered by the Telangana government to be implemented for the non-resident Telanganites. In Kerala, there is a department named Non-Resident Keralite Affairs Department. This department will try to redress the grievances of the non-resident Keralites, especially those who are living in the Gulf countries. So through this department, Kerala government is providing Pravasi ID card. So providing Pravasi ID card would mean that Kerala government can trace the persons through these IDs and can provide them with beneficiary schemes such as providing insurance cards and skill training and skill upgradation to get the right kind of placement. So this model has been studied by the Telangana government to be implemented same for the non-resident Telanganites. Our next topic is about the Telangana government is to sign agreement with the NHRDF. NHRDF means National Horticultural Research and Development Foundation. So Telangana government is set to sign an agreement. So it is basically to increase the production of onions to check the prices. See, we have seen spike in the onion prices recent times. The main reason for the spike in the onion prices recently is the lower production levels. So the production levels has been hit by the monsoonal flooding, especially in those states where the onion production is taken up, onion production is high, such as states of Karnataka and the Maharashtra. So due to the lower production of the onion, the prices of the onion spikes up. So to contain that onion price, to check the onion price, now the Telangana government is taking up the production of these onions. So for that purpose, Telangana government is taking the help of the National Horticulture Research and Developmental Foundation. For that, it will be signing an agreement with this organization. This NHRDF will provide seeds of the red and the dark red and the white onions to the farmers, and it will also provide some technical know-how and how the techniques of onion cultivation. Basically, Telangana's environment, the climatic conditions that prevail in Telangana, the state of Telangana, are most suitable for the onion cultivation. But onion cultivation is not taken up by the farmers in Telangana. So to promote the onion cultivation in Telangana, now the Telangana government is inking an agreement with this body. If we see the nationwide, India occupies the second place after China in the onion production, and it is one of the largest exporter of onions, and onion constitute around 67% of the total vegetable exports. That means if we take the total vegetables, onion itself constitutes 67% of total exports. This is because there is a huge demand for onions across various states, which include Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Nepal and Malaysia. Our next topic is about Telangana GenCo has been awarded for excellence in e-governance. This award has been given to this Telangana GenCo because of its adoption of or implementation of the centralized ERP solutions. ERP here means enterprise response planning. So Telangana GenCo has implemented this centralized enterprise response planning across all its plants and all corporate offices. So this implementation has led to a new era of information management in the organization of this Telangana GenCo. So the key benefits of this initiative includes real-time tracking of files to multiple stakeholders with improved transparency and accountability, and online movement of digital files with pre-configured workflow, quick and easy retrieval of digital files, and reduction in paper consumption. Because of all these benefits and the new initiative of this Telangana GenCo, the Computer Society of India Special Interest Group has awarded e-governance award for excellence at the 53rd annual convention. So in that context, we are studying about this. With this session, we'll conclude our discussion for today, as well as we have completed all the discussion on the February current affairs magazine prepared by the AKS IAS. I hope it will be helpful for you in the UPSC prelims 2020, as well as in other competitive examinations. Thanks for watching.